just grasp your attention this morning. In the book of Psalms, the 14th chapter. Psalms, the 14th chapter. The first three verses of the 14th Psalm. In your pew Bibles. We ask that when you have found it, please stand. Reverence the Lord's word. Amen. We're so glad to see everyone out here. Amen. God is truly a good God. Amen. We're especially glad to see Sister Parkins' family. Amen. I said the way Sister Parkins ran over there, I said, okay, that's her family. Beautiful family. Amen.
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 Yeah.
Thank you, Lord. Fourth in the song, and reads it so the first three verses. Amen.
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 The fool says in his heart, there is no God. They are corrupt. Their deeds are vile.
There is no one who does good.
The Lord looks down in heaven and the sons of men to see if there are any who understand, any who seek God. All have turned aside, and they together become corrupt. There is no one who does good, not even one. Amen.
Amen.
Thank God for His word. The Bible says His word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our paths. Amen. Pass me
by, O gentle Savior.
You've got.
All right.
Look to your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Realizing
what
you
got.
What you got.
What you got.
What you got. Yes.
All right now.
God is truly a good God.
Yes, He is.
Beloved, it's me looking to this first verse of Psalms 14, David. Bible says that the fool has said in his heart, there is no God. The kind of fool that God is referring to here is a person of atheistic beliefs. The belief that God does not exist. Now we, beloved, we are now in the season of wintertime. And that's been a season of winter time like I've never seen before.
Amen.
Isn't God all right?
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Nice 60 and 70 degree days that we've had just a few weeks prior. The cost of gas, the cost of oil has all went down.
Yeah,
I believe that's enough for everyone to shout on right there.
Yeah.
I don't know about about you, but beloved, but I am thankful for God's mercy.
Yes.
Now, beloved, before we had winter time, we had the season of fall. Right? It was a seasonally mild, and yes, some of us had to rake some leaves and do some yard chores.
Yeah.
And before fall, we had summer. Yes. Summer was mild and also enjoyable.
Yes.
We were able to barbecue and enjoy our families. Isn't God all right?
All right. Yes.
And after this winter time, beloved, we'll all have springtime. Yes. Are you with me?
All right.
Amen.
To plant our flowers and to prepare the yards for summer and for that season. Amen?
Yes.
Isn't God all right?
Yes.
And it's God and God alone that creates and orchestrates us through each and every season just the same of our lives.
Amen.
Isn't God all right?
Yes.
I'm sure so many of us look back to the day you were once 16 and 25 years old. Just take a ride back for a minute. It's not too far back. Amen. You were young. You were strong. You were vibrant. You could run all day and night. You didn't need very much sleep at all. Your energy level was unexplainable.
Yes.
Amen. I'm sure we remember those days.
Yes.
A lot of us today, we still have those days. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Beloved, don't let your age fool you. You still got what it takes. And now and even more. Amen.
Amen.
You're wiser. You know more now than you knew back then.
Amen.
We are fearfully and wonderfully made.
Yes.
Is it all right?
Yes.
I want you to raise your hands. Feel it. I want you to feel it.
Yes.
How you feel it?
Yes.
Yeah. You strong?
Yeah.
But the fool has said in his heart, there is no God.
All right.
Amen.
The Bible tells us in Genesis chapter 1, in the beginning God created the heaven and the earth, and goes through the list of creation to verse 26, and God said, let us make man in our image.
All right.
After our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. So God created man in his own image. Are you with me this morning?
Yeah.
Isn't God all right?
Yeah.
In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. God did it. Amen.
Yeah.
Look to your neighbor and say, neighbor, God did it.
God did it.
Years long ago, I was living in Korea. And we began to talk about God, me and this brother. And this man began to profess that he was an atheist. And I began to ask the man some questions, and he said he didn't believe in God. So I said, why do you say that you're an atheist? The man began to become angry and said, I don't know why. I don't know why I'm an atheist. So I realized that this man professed something that he clearly did not know what he was saying. Are you with me this morning? Beloved, we will run into people in life who will not know what they're talking about concerning God. Do you have any witnesses in here today?
Yeah.
You see, beloved, you have experiences and revelations and guidance from God.
Amen.
The precious Holy Spirit. Amen?
Amen.
You have seen God at work for yourselves.
Amen.
Do I have any witnesses today?
Yeah. Yeah.
You have seen God heal.
Yes.
You have seen God deliver
yes.
Yourself as well as others in your family from many things that you've prayed and you've asked God for.
Yes. Yeah.
So, beloved, we are witnesses to the grace and goodness of God.
Yes.
The scripture says, if it had not been for the Lord on my side, where would we be? So there is nothing that can persuade you and I to think any differently about God. Are you with me?
Yes.
Now, beloved, a friend of mine, she had posted on Facebook a picture of her beautiful 2016 Mercedes, in which her husband bought her. She said that God, she stated, God is good. God is good.
Yes.
What she did was she gave God the glory.
Amen.
Beloved, we've got to give God the glory in all that he does for you and I.
Amen.
Now, beloved, I spent 6 years in the military. Now, within that time, we did training exercises which you would not see the conventional shower with soap and water, all that fancy stuff.
That's right.
And you wouldn't see this stuff for weeks. So things became a little rough. So now, every time that I step into that shower, my wife hears me all the time, I can't help but to tell the Lord, within where we're going, you've got to always remember and keep in mind from where you came to where you're going. And that it was God that brought you through. And it's God now who is going to, God alone, who is only going to bring us through. And that is very second. It's very second, but the fool that said in his heart, there is no God. The Bible tells us that the Psalms 24:1 tells us that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. And they that dwell therein. So we see here, beloved, everything belongs to God. We are stewards to that which God has entrusted us.
All right.
I knew a guy years ago, and he began to tell me, Kurt, you know, when my father died, I went to the house and I took the boat. Now, mind you, he had brothers and sisters. He tells me now, when my mother dies, I'll probably have to fight them for the house. To get my third. I began to think to myself, I said, where is the value within having your family within their lives? I said, did you love them or the things that you wanted from them? Had he known, as you and I know, that Psalms 37 tells us that if you shall delight thyself in the Lord, also that he shall give you the desires of thine heart. Isn't God all right? You see, beloved, this is the God that we serve.
Amen.
He says, if you be willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land.
Yes.
But the fool has said in his heart, there is no God. Who is it that puts the stars and the moon in the sky?
Right now.
Well, you say there is no God. Who is it that understands my sorrows and knows my pain?
That's right.
The Bible tells us that all things were made by him.
All right. Yes.
And without him, there was not anything made that was made.
That's right.
Isn't God all right?
Yes.
So, beloved, take notice in the beauty and craftsmanship of everything that we see and use daily. A woman would not be able to vacuum without a vacuum. A man would not be able to paint without a paintbrush. It's God and God alone that places the intellect into mankind to be able to create things for our use. Isn't God all right? I believe he's worthy of that much more of a praise from y'all just for that. I was at a family get-together, And I noticed that everybody was on their cell phone. So I asked them, what would you do if you no longer had a cell phone? They looked at me like I had two heads. Like they looked at me like, what you talking about, Willis? None of them really gave me an answer. But I knew that was something that they did not want to give up. Now, beloved, we've all had things and have things that we did not want to give up.
Amen.
When I was in the world, I was wrapped up, tied up in my world of sin. I had a friend that knew the Lord, that seen the error of my ways. He was trying to tell me, as I'm telling you, please come into the Lord's house. I was trying my best to run the other way. Yeah. I learned over in Romans 3:23, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God.
Amen.
So I learned, and I got to see that my friend was trying to tell me to his best to help me. Uh-huh. Likewise, as I am trying to help you.
Yes.
The thing I love about Jesus, beloved, is that Jesus, in Luke 14:28, Jesus, he speaks to disciples. And he lets them know of the conditions for discipleship. Jesus poses the question for like this. He says, for which of you intending to build a tower, sitteth not down first and counteth the cost, whether he has sufficient to finish? I realize, beloved, that within life we've all had to count up the cost. Are you with me?
Amen.
I remember, beloved, I used to talk with my grandmother for years. She did not have a companion. So she had become settled and comfortable within her ways of being by herself.
Yeah.
She would tell me, Kurt, baby, listen here. I don't need no nappy head man telling me what to do. Beloved, within all her years of life, she counted up the course of the possible aggravation, betrayal that she might go through. She realized that she was better off by herself.
That's right.
When folks get married, they tend to count up the course of each other. Is he handsome? Does he work a job? What kind of job does he work? How long has he been on the job? How much money does he earn? Is he kind and considerate to me? How well does he get along with my family? Is he any kind of a provider or protector? Does he have a plan? What kind of education does he have? And it goes on, does she know how to take care of a house? Is she willing to work? Would she be a good mother? How does she dress? How does she carry herself? Does she pay bills? Does she create bills? Is she attentive to my needs? These are questions that you count up the cost concerning before marriage. And even within a marriage, you will still continue, let the truth be told, you will still continue to count up the cost. Every now and then, you'll look over at your spouse, and you'll say, well, you've seen me through that valley, and you've helped me over that hill. We've been over that edge, and we've pulled each other from that cliff. Yeah. You'll sit back and you'll look at them. I don't know about you, but every now and then I'll sit back and I'll look at them. Yeah. The thought will go through your mind of your spouse and all that you've been through, all that you guys have been through together. Now, beloved, I like watching my Home and Garden television shows every now and then. And within watching them, a husband and wife will count up the cost of affordability of the kind of house that they like. A three-bedroom or a four-bedroom, a large yard or a small yard, the location of the house, how many bathrooms. They'll look at various homes and count up the cost to make a decision as to which one they want and need. And which one they can afford. Now, beloved, Michael Jackson had a song. And the song was, I'm looking
in the mirror.
At the man in the mirror. The lyrics say, I'm looking at the man in the mirror and I'm asking him to change his ways. Every now and then, beloved, I look into the mirror. The mirror of my life within myself. I realize that I've got to count up the cost within my life. Every now and then as I look into the mirror, I've got to ask myself some questions.
All right.
Could I be doing better than I'm doing now? Instead of being angry, could I be more forgiving than what I am now? Now, beloved, God is a merciful God.
Yes.
I say, well, brother preacher, how do you know? Because he tells us in Psalms 23. He says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all.